Hello everyone, Chris Laskowski here with Sea Vision Productions. In volume 2 of our Montana Rail Link coverage, we visit MRL's west end between Helena, Montana and Sandpoint, Idaho. Mullan Pass and Evaro Hill are featured in this video, along with extensive coverage of the Paradise and Gas locals. In addition to the main line, we'll see one of the final revenue moves over the Darby branch in April of 2013. So put your calls on hold and turn your speakers up as we take a tour of MRL's west end.
In Volume 2 of our coverage of the Montana Rail Link, we follow the railroad's main line from Helena, Montana to Sandpoint, Idaho, over the MRL's 3rd and 4th subdivisions. Along with the main line, we will cover two of the railroad's secondary and branch lines. First, the 9th sub-branch in the Bitterroot Valley south of Missoula, followed by the 10th subdivision between DeSmet and Paradise via Evaro Hill. The 10th sub is used as a shortcut for light eastbound trains and is the preferred route for the gas local in both directions. Beginning with the 3rd sub, we will work our way west from Helena over Mullan Pass to Missoula. In Helena, we view the picturesque former Northern Pacific Depot, located at the west end of MRL's Helena Yard. Helena is a crew change point and is home base for Mullan Pass helper operations. A 4-unit Helena helper set departs the engine servicing area bound for Helena Junction. At Helena Junction, this helper will be cut into a westbound train for the trip over Mullan Pass. Shortly after cutting in their helper at Helena Junction, this westbound Roberts Bank coal train is approaching the end of two main tracks at Tobin and has already begun the steep climb to the summit of Mullan Pass. Although the grade may look impressive here, the most challenging territory still lies ahead. A few hours later at Bird's Eye, we view a herd of pronghorn as they pass by our camera. The pronghorn didn't seem very concerned by our presence as they go about their business. High above Skyline Trestle, we view a Kansas City to Spokane train as it struggles up the pass without helper assistance. We have reached the Continental Divide and the summit of Mullan Pass at Blossburg, elevation 5,548 feet above sea level. With nightfall fast approaching, we patiently await the arrival of a Centralia coal train. This train has just conquered the long 2.2% westbound grade on the east side of Mullan Pass and has already started down the 1.4% descending grade. The mid-train helper will stay on to Elliston. This allows the train to safely negotiate the summit and will provide additional braking for the descent down the west side of Mullan Pass. Having just crossed underneath Interstate 90, MRL 346 West arrives in Garrison. Garrison is the junction with BNSF's Copper City sub from Butte, and is also home to a small yard used for interchange between MRL and BNSF. Just east of Nimrod, we view an endangered pair of searchlight signals as we await the arrival of an eastbound unit train. Thank you. Many of the older searchlight signals in this area were continuously lit, giving the observer a good indication as to what was happening. Here, we see the signal begin to clear up as the train moves further east. At the former station location of Bonita, both the MRL and Milwaukee Road right-of-ways encounter short tunnels. We will take advantage of this interesting location to view two trains. Arriving in Bonner, this switch job will pull clear of the siding and perform a little work before returning to Missoula. This side of Bonner is also known as Milltown.
Thank you.
We have arrived in Missoula, milepost 119.3. Missoula is the site of a large yard and is home to a fair amount of local business. Missoula is a crew change point, with road crews working east to Helena and west to Hauser and Spokane. MRL's headquarters are also located here, making Missoula a very important place for the railroad. Next, we will take a brief look at MRL's 9th Subdivision. The line no longer has any active customers, but we were fortunate to capture a single Darby local on the branch before regular service ended several years ago. Having completed their work in Victor, the Darby local departs for Stevensville, where they will make a pickup before heading into Missoula. Returning to mainline operations, we will now cover the 10th subdivision between DeSmet and Paradise. Evaro Hill is encountered just west of DeSmet and features 2.2% grades leading to the summit in both directions. Because of this, the 10th sub is used as a shortcut for lighter trains, such as empty grain and coal, as well as the gas local. The night gas local departs DeSmet up the 10th sub, and shortly will begin the steep climb up Evaro Hill. DeSmet is the point where the 4th and 10th subdivision split. The main closest to us is the 4th sub, while the main the train is on transitions from main 1 of the 4th sub to main track of the 10th sub here at DeSmet. Snaking its way down Evaro Hill, the day gas local is returning to Missoula with its train of empty tank cars out of pipeline. The gas local operates between Missoula and a Phillips 66 facility just east of Thompson Falls, Montana. This local performs an essential service for Phillips 66 as it provides a vital link in the company's pipeline across western Montana. The train operates west with loads and returns east with empties. Before the train left DeSmet, we listened in as the dispatcher issued the crew a track warrant.
A mandatory directive, make a track warrant number 1187, 1187. 2 MRL Montana Rail Link 4312-4312 West WEST. Xbox 2 TWO proceed from CTC DeSmet, DESMET. 2 CTC Paradise, PARADISE. On 10th, 1 knot sub main track. One box mark, number 2, over.
The 10th sub follows the Flathead River between Dixon and Paradise, making the scenery along this portion of the line some of the best on the MRL west of Missoula. The day gas local is seen as it heads east shortly after leaving Paradise. Heading back to DeSmet, we will cover the 4th subdivision west to the end of the railroad at Sandpoint. A monster gas local departs DeSmet and will run out the 4th sub this evening. Although the 4th sub to Paradise is longer and slower than the 10th, the 4th is the preferred route for heavy trains, such as tonight's gas local. If this train was to be routed over the 10th, it would have required a helper to get over Evaro Hill. Thank you. At a location known as Plateau, a westbound grain train slowly makes its way along the Clark Fork River and will soon enter the short Plateau Tunnel located beneath us. After the train passes, we view firefighting efforts just west of town. It is mid-July, and the western wildfire season is just getting underway. The Paradise Local is seen as it works its way towards St. Regis. Due to a steady decline in business, the Paradise Local was abolished in the fall of 2015, with the Gas Local assuming the Paradise's responsibilities. The fourth sub closely follows the Clark Fork River for many miles in western Montana. The Clark Fork and its many tributaries are crossed numerous times west of Missoula, providing photographers many excellent locations to view trains along this portion of the railroad. A westbound Roberts Bank coal train crosses the Clark Fork, heading geographically east towards Paradise. On another day, the Paradise crew pulls down to the east end of the yard and will soon begin building their train for the trip east. With work complete, the Paradise departs for Tricon with a healthy train in tow. ballast train heads west for Kootenay behind a matching pair of SD40-2XRs. We will see this train several more times as it makes its way west across the 4th sub. Detoured Z train blasts out of Trout Creek and will make excellent time to the end of the railroad at Sandpoint. From this point on, the scenery continues to become more spectacular as the railroad nears the Idaho border. At the west end of Hope Siding, we have set up to view a meet between a Pasco to Belt Railway of Chicago train and a familiar Laurel to Spokane Manifest. A woodland critter is hard at work as we await the arrival of an eastbound stack train at the Pack River Fill west of Hope. We have reached the end of the MRL here in Sandpoint. Lake Ponderay is a recreational paradise, and we see many boaters and jet skiers out enjoying the evening on the open water. Having just entered BNSF trackage, a Seattle-bound stack train crosses Lake Ponderay as it continues its westward journey. Back in DeSmet, we will view one more train to close out our show. We were fortunate to capture an exciting yet brief era on MRL, one full of surprises and opportunity. We'd like to thank you for joining us and hope you've enjoyed our journey along the Montana Rail Link.